Hi, in this video we'll take a closer look on green laser pointers. They have become so cheap that lots of people now own them, but may not be aware of a major safety issue with the cheap ones. To save costs, an important component to filter out invisible infrared laser radiation may be missing in your laser. I will test my green lasers for this, and even test if the mighty Hercules has this issue. Powerful lasers will damage your eyes. Always use laser safety glasses, especially when using reflective glass in front of them and invisible lasers as I do in this video. Now, I'm used to handling powerful lasers with a visible beam. They can be scary enough, but powerful invisible laser beams give me shivers. Therefore, I have bought some pro-level safety glasses that will protect my eyes against both green and infrared beams. I cringe at the price of these, but my eyes, my vision, is worth a lot more to me. It may be a surprise to most that green lasers can emit infrared radiation too. Why would they do this? Aren't lasers supposed to be monochromatic, tightly centered around one wavelength? 532 nanometers in the case of the common green lasers. Actually, all the radiation from such a laser starts as infrared. Inside it is a powerful infrared 808 nanometers laser that is converted to 1064 nanometers infrared, which is then converted to the visible 532 nanometers green. The crystals aren't 100% efficient at converting the infrared. A textbook design therefore has a filter that blocks the remaining infrared but lets the visible laser light through. This DPSS design is relatively complicated and expensive. So to make cheap laser pointers, it is tempting to simply leave out the infrared filter or only include a dirt cheap inefficient one. I want to see what they did with my green lasers, but how can I tell if the lasers emit invisible infrared radiation? Many, if not most, digital cameras will detect near infrared light. Here, I test my camera with some ordinary remote controls. My eyes cannot see this low-level infrared radiation, but the camera can. Oddly enough, it is recorded as a violet color, even though it is a deep, deep red color. But I don't trust my camera for all infrared wavelengths and want a more direct way to see an infrared beam without shining it directly into my camera. The green laser beam is also very bright, so I need to filter that out before making a clear detection of infrared light. The solution is optical filters. I found some affordable ones on eBay. One lets infrared light pass through, but blocks visible light. And another one lets visible light pass, but blocks infrared light. To make infrared visible, I've also bought some different IR cards. Two of them are affordable, and the third has a huge detection area and price tag. They will all detect the IR from a remote control. One of them is even meant for it. The green one is for much more intense radiation than from a remote control, but will emit a noticeable green light in a dark room, more visible to my eyes than to the camera. Since I always question unbranded stuff bought online and want a control test to see how infrared radiation behaves in my setup, I bought some infrared lasers too. One emitting 808 nanometers like the pump diode in a green laser, and one emitting 980 nanometers. Unfortunately, I couldn't find a cheap 1064 nanometers laser to represent the other infrared wavelength in a green laser pointer, but my setup should work for that wavelength too. Let's try the 980 laser first. It is not visible to the camera or my eyes until it hits one of the detection areas on any of the cards. There, I can clearly see it as either an orange or green dot on the cards. The 808 laser is a little different. It is detected by the camera and only works well with the two orange cards. The green one has little to no reaction with this wavelength since it is outside the card's detection range. The green card, however, has an advantage. It doesn't need to be recharged with white light. The two orange ones need a recharge once in a while to have maximum response. Now we can test if the optical filters work as advertised. The black one should let infrared pass, while the clear one should block infrared. Yep, the black one does let infrared pass and clearly blocks visible light since it looks opaque to our eyes. Let's put the clear filter in between and see if it really blocks infrared. Ah yes, we have a setup working as intended. This is perfect for detecting any infrared leaking from a green laser pointer. I've got three cheap unbranded green lasers to test. Let's start with the weakest one. It is supposed to be less than 5 milliwatts, but it may be more as explained in one of my earlier videos. Oh dear, not a good start. It is clearly emitting infrared as detected on the card. Let's try a more powerful one at 50 milliwatts. Great, this one is leaking infrared too. Here's a different laser for comparison, a 505 nanometer cyan green laser. There's no infrared coming from this one, since it is not a DPSS laser. No infrared laser diode inside it, just one emitting 505 nanometers directly. It's the same with Blu-ray lasers. They have a laser diode emitting 405 nanometers laser light directly. No infrared from these two. Same story with red laser pointers. Nothing detected from this orange red at 638 nanometers. The powerful 200 milliwatt 660 nanometers laser reacts a little differently. The black filter can't completely block this wavelength at this power level. But no infrared is coming from this laser. No orange dot on the card, and it goes through the clear filter too. Alright, let's try the last of my cheap green lasers. It is also up to 50 milliwatts. Look at this ridiculous label. It says class 3A, but that class is only for lasers up to 5 milliwatts. Don't trust this laser to comply with any regulations, even though it says so at the bottom line. Not surprisingly, this one emits infrared too. It appears to be a very common issue with the unbranded green lasers. I also own some branded green lasers from Laserglow. They are very expensive, so they better have an infrared filter in them. First up is the Ares. This one has a 1200 milliwatts infrared pump diode, so I wouldn't be surprised if a little infrared comes through even if it is filtered. My IR filter still lets up to 2% through. Here we go, time to see if this is a quality laser or not. Now this is how it is supposed to look like. Little to no infrared light is coming through. Only a massive amount of green laser light as expected. Let's step it up a notch to my most powerful green laser, the Hercules. We are now dealing with a 2500 milliwatts infrared pump diode. Surely some of it must make it through to the output. No, I don't see any infrared leakage. The quality of the infrared filter must be sky high, as the rest of the components. This is a high quality laser. I love it. The conclusion based on my green lasers is clear. Cheap, unbranded ones should be assumed to always emit infrared radiation, while expensive branded ones can have proper filtering. So, it is a good idea to buy a small infrared filter and use it in front of the cheapos. With some lasers, you may even be able to take the housing apart and fit the filter inside it. If you buy a smaller filter than I did. Anyway, as always, be careful when handling lasers. Maybe they are emitting more than you can see, and I want you to be able to watch my future videos. Thanks for watching. Subscribe if you want to see more laser and science videos. I have also finally launched a Patreon account, so go check that out. Link in the description. Any support is appreciated. Even a like makes me smile, so click like if you did like the video. Bye for now.